going to go over some of the key points that are added into this. So when you do pull the back, you want to be sure to press down at the back to make sure that that lock engages. The other key point is the maximum amount of fuel that gets involved is the cartridge. So that's how many we would load into that. Then we're going to place the nozzle over top where it was the desired. So stand firmly, knees slightly bent, standing upright. What this actually does is it's keeping the floor or the floor drill level. It allows to avoid that binding and steering and having that depth issue. So it countersinks properly. We're going to engage the pneumatic. Now again, not holding it down, it only needs to be pressed to be engaged. And then we're going the reason why you don't want to do that is you don't want to overtax the pneumatic system. Now we're going to engage the drill. Again, at that 3/4 RPM going through the wood. You can let off slightly once you hit that cross section, and that will avoid that steering and that depth issue, the binding and whatnot. But you want it to still be fairly consistent. Always run. Level on the drill, making sure that there's nothing under the back of the drill. Okay? So, I'm going to have you now